One of the best comforts after going through tragedy is finding something to hold on to. And on this week's Community Spotlight, Mel Meyer tells us how one organization is giving children in need much more than a security blanket.
Inside Trinity Lutheran Church, scissors snip away. Sewing machines whir to life. And after a few last stitches, volunteers add little prayer notes on 300 blankets to go to children in area hospitals.
It's a very huge undertaking, but very rewarding at that.
The volunteers are helping create the annual stockpile of blankets for infants to teenagers for Project Linus. The Northern Chapter delivers the gifts anywhere from Thief River Falls to Grand Rapids, Roseau to Bemidji.
We just try to reach out to all kids in crisis that would benefit from a blanket.
They usually don't know who the blankets are intended for, but sometimes they get specialty calls. Last fall, they delivered blankets to the school classroom of a 7-year-old boy who died crossing a road in Thief River Falls.
The little kids would say, "How did you know pink was my favorite color? How did you know I like puppies? Oh, it's so warm and cuddly. I'll always remember my friend when I wrap in this blanket."
Being able to pick out the fabrics to go to the children is one of Amy Nygaard's favorite parts.
It's fun to pick out lots of different patterns and that, you know, kids will like.
When Mackenzie Ellis and her family heard about the cause, they decided to lend a helping hand.
We really like sewing and we thought it was a cool way to use that to help kids.
The help is surely appreciated. If the organization knows who made the blanket, they'll add the person's contact information so the child can send a thank you note.
Oftentimes you do get a thank you, sometimes even a picture back saying how the blanket impacted their lives.
The organization says that there is a need for more blankets for teenagers. In Bemidji with this week's Community Spotlight, I'm Mel Meyer, Lakeland News.
If you've enjoyed this segment of Lakeland News, please consider making a tax-deductible contribution to Lakeland Public Television.